Your previous video, we have discussed how to create a new React Native project, okay, and how to execute it. Okay, in this video, we will just discuss the file and the folder structure of React Native project. Okay, so if you have not yet gone through our previous session, then I request you all to please do watch our previous session first, okay, and then proceed with this one. Okay, so in our previous session, when we create a project, that is my first React Native application, in React Native folder, if you remember, see here in React Native tutorial folder, here we create this particular project, okay, and when we create project, at that time by default it has created some files and folders. Okay, so as far as this session is concerning, here we will just discuss use of those files and folders. Okay, now see, as I said earlier, this tutorial series is only designed for beginners. Okay, now here see, so many files and folders it has automatically created, but most of these files we will use at intermediate or at advanced level. Okay, at a beginner level we are using very few files. Okay, but then also here in this video we will just discuss the use of each and every file and folder here. Okay, so here see, this is the first folder which is automatically get created when you create React Native new React Native project. Okay, that folder is __test__. Okay, basically see, this particular folder will be useful at intermediate or at advanced level. Okay, as the name suggests, see, this folder is used to store the test cases. Okay, so generally when we write test cases after successful implementation, after completion of coding, we usually write test cases. Okay, for example, suppose if 10 components if we create in our project, and if you want to write a test cases for every component by using Jest, then the code for writing those test cases we will just store in this __test__ folder. Okay, so by default it has created one test case. Okay, so at beginner level we are not going to access this particular folder. Okay, then second folder is VS Code folder. So this is again a folder which is automatically get created when you create a new React Native project using VS Code. Okay, you will be using Visual Studio Code Editor. So this folder is used to store some configuration files related with the React Native project as far as VS Code is concerning. Okay, then next two folders are there, that is Android and iOS folder. Okay, see, in earlier case we have already discussed a point that this React Native project, which React Native project we create? My first React Native application. Okay, so this is a React Native project. So if you create a project in React Native, then that particular project we can execute on Android as well as in iOS platform. Okay, now if you want to execute this React Native project on Android platform, then whatever files required for that, those files will get stored in Android folder. And similarly, if you want to execute this particular React Native project on iOS platform, then whatever required file for that, those files will get stored in iOS folder. Okay, or sometime we may, while writing a code in our project, we may use some dependencies which will be useful only in case of Android. So if this is the case, then such dependencies we can store in Android. So same case is there with iOS as well. Okay, so in simple word, you just remember point that Android and iOS folders are used to store the files which we will require to execute this React Native application in Android and iOS platform sequentially. Okay, then next folder is node module folder. Okay, during during environment setup video, we have installed several node modules. So those node modules will get stored in this node modules folder. Okay, how to set up an environment and how to install the node modules, all these things we have already discussed. Okay, so during installation, whatever node module that we have installed, those node modules will get stored under node module folder. Okay, now next are some files. Okay, so here around 6 to 7 files are there, which are start with dot. See here, dot. Okay, those files are configuration files. We will use we will discuss its use in detail later on. Okay, now here question arises that when we execute this particular project, okay, by using which command? By using this command, generally we execute React Native project. Okay, that is React-Native /React-Android. So when we execute this project, then from where exactly execution begin of a React Native application is always begin from index.js file. Okay, let me open this file. See, this is a index.js file. From this file execution will begin. Okay, now if you observe this particular file here, initially it has imported some packages. Okay, In detail, we will discuss the meaning of all these packages in our subsequent video. Okay, but as far as this video is concerning, here I just want to give you a brief overview. So as I said earlier, when you execute this project, then execution will begin from this index.js file. Okay, so here I have opened that index.js file. So at the start here, we have imported some packages. Okay, and then this line will be executed. After execution of this line, what will happen? See, it will just check for app.js file. Here, whatever file that you have assigned here at this point, it will just try to look for this file, app.js file. Okay, means from index.js file, control will be transferred to app.js file. Okay, but in our last video, we have already discussed after execution, we have got this type of output. Okay, so from where exactly it is just going to print this type of output, that part we are going to discuss here. Okay, so as I said earlier, initially control will be in index.js. Okay, here we import some packages, and then here for this we assign app. Okay, app file. Okay, so whatever file name that you are assigning here, so framework will just try to search for this JS file, app.js file. Okay, so here let me open app.js file. See, this is our app.js file, app.js file. Okay, and this was the default output that we have got earlier. Okay, see here, step one, see your changes. So somewhere they have written the code for this as well, welcome to React. Okay, so where actually the code for this particular file is written? In app.js file. Okay, so let me show you the code of app.js file as well. See here, this is the code of app.js file. See here, step one, app.js. What is the meaning of all these tags? That particular thing we'll discuss in detail. So here, see, edit to text change. So let me show you output so that it will be easy for you to understand. See here, here edit, step one. See, this is step one code for printing this step one. Then app.js file, edit app.js to change the screen. So the code for this one is written in this app.js file. Okay, so as I said earlier, initially when you execute this particular project, then first of all it will just check for index.js, and from index.js whatever file name that you are assigning here, it will just look for that file. So here we have assigned app, so control will be transferred to app.js, and this code will be executed. Okay, and we are getting this type of output. Okay, then a few more files are there. Okay, for example, here see package.json file is also there, package.json. okay, so here are some dependencies, whatever dependencies that we require for execution of this particular project, those dependencies are usually mentioned in package.json file. Then one more file is there, that is package.log.json. okay, package.log.json. so here also a few more dependencies are mentioned. Okay, so next is here metro.config file is there, metro.config file. This is again a configuration file. See, as a developer, we are not accessing this file frequently, but what is use of metro.config file is, see, this file is generally used to make our build process faster and scalable. Okay, you must have to remember this particular point. If you want to make your build process faster and scalable, then for that purpose we may require to access this metro.config file. Then okay, so next file is watchman.config file. See, React Native support one very good feature called as hot reload. Okay, unlike other cross-platform framework, one additional and very useful feature which is included in React Native framework called as hot reload. Okay, so what exactly this feature is? See, in React Native application, as soon as you make changes in your code, those changes will automatically get reflected in your emulator before compiling particular program. Okay, for example, initially what I said, see, the code for this one is stored in which file? In app.js file. Okay, so here if I make any change, then those changes will automatically get reflected here on this particular output. Okay, for example, here if I write, suppose here instead of edit, here if I write, let us change this particular file statement for better understanding. Okay, and here I'm just going to write welcome. Okay, so when I save this particular change, then see here, automatically those changes will get reflected here. Okay, I have not compiled this particular program. Before compiling, it is just going to reflect the change in the emulator. Okay, so this feature is called as hot reload feature. Okay, so if you want to access this particular feature, then for that purpose, this particular file is added in your project directory, watchman config file. to next are dot git attribute and git ignore files. See, if you want to configure this particular project, that is my first React Native application project on Git, okay, that is on version control system, then for that purpose these two files will be helpful. Okay, then next one is a bug config file. See, in some earlier version of React Native, the build process was very slow. Okay, and in recent version of React Native, they have added this bug config, and because of this reason, the build process in the recent version of React Native become much faster as compared to previous one. Okay, then one more file is there, that is esliteracy.js. Okay, what is use of this particular file is, if you want to place some validation code for your project, then that particular code we can write in esliteracy.js file. Okay, now validation code means, for example, suppose while writing a code in your project, if you want to keep all constants, let us say if you want to keep all constants in capital case, then the code for that particular part we can write in esliteracy.js. okay, so in short you can remember the point that the esliteracy.js, in esliteracy.js file we can write some validation related code. Okay, and finally the flow config file, which is used to change the flow of your project. Okay, so as I said earlier, don't worry, at beginner level we don't require to access all these files. Okay, usually at beginner level we only access this index.js, then app.js. okay, and sometime we may require to create our own folder as well, so those points in detail we will discuss in our subsequent videos. Okay, so in this video we have discussed the file and the folder structure of default React Native project. Okay, so if you find any difficulty in understanding any point, then you can ask your queries through comments. Okay, so that's all for this session. Stay tuned for further updates. Thank you.